come across it. So it's just putting a name to actually what you are doing. So what is aspect oriented programming? So similar to functional programming or object oriented programming, like aspect oriented programming is just like a style of programming. So what it does is just it increases the modularity of the code. So what this means that like you can separate the code and use it in different areas. So how this works is like adds additional behavior to the code without altering the output of the code. So for example, if you have a certain function and you're looking for certain results, you go inside and then mess it up and then to get something else that you want. But ultimately, the output still remains the same. So okay, that's what it means. Cuts open the codes and then change some stuff inside to get some desired results that you want. So this happens when you're using certain functions that you require. Like for example, how I came across this was because we were using some middleware for Express. So this was how we came across aspect-oriented programming. And apparently it's a patented technology sort of thing. So you can find out more about it on MDN. Okay, so there's some keywords to make you sound pro when you're talking to your friends. So there are mainly four of them. So the first one is cross-cutting concerns. So this is when you try to separate the computing side from actually the business side. So for example, if you're having like a banking app where you need to do transfers. So the app itself needs to be able to process the transfers. And on the other side, we need to be concerned about the security issues. So like the logging issues for the consumers. So these are two separate issues. And that's why they call it cost-cutting concerns. Okay, so that's the first keyword. Okay, the second one is about aspects. So they're just objects which link to other parts of the code. Basically that's it. Okay, and then point cuts are like event triggers. So there are certain pieces of the code where you try to insert these points for these aspects into. Okay, and then the last one would be advice. So which is section of the code which executes the point cut. So these are the event handlers. So which is actually your action in trying to mash up the code to get the desired results that you want. So these are the four keywords which you can use to show off. Yeah, but basically that's about it for aspect oriented programming. Yeah, so quick one, not so mind boggling. Yeah, that's all.
How do you do it in JavaScript?
Syntax.
Is that
good?
Yes.
What
everybody wants.
Oh, yeah. I forgot to include that.
Libraries or...
Hold on. Yeah. Let's see. So this is what I did for the project. So essentially what trying to create a cocktail library. So what we did was we were trying to create the filters for like the glass types and the ingredients and the filter name. So this was the middleware which I was playing with, and which is essentially which uses the AOP itself. So what it does is that when we get the JSON file, we play around with it, or we included the other functions, the other filters like the glass ingredient, but the output essentially still remains the same. So you still return the old JSON, which is here. Yeah, so yeah, that's the AOP itself. Yeah. So this is one example of it. I couldn't find simpler or more interesting examples online, but maybe if you all have, you can share, I guess. Yeah. Yeah, that's about it.